very he's played for the team in this region. He kind of calls it his second home, and says he's really treated very well here. And I think the reception he got there as he came out and called here to take on Rumbaka suggests that that is true. The number one seed then against the man from Indonesia.
That's a cruel way of putting this thing.
It wouldn't be that much fun pulling down, beating up Chinese players. It's always more fun if you can win against a foreigner.
Well, Wang Zhengmin potentially awaits in the next round. Interesting, I was reading the quotes from this young man. He is a young man in terms of his experience there. Regarded as one of the potential rising stars in Indonesia. Came through against Misha Silberman, not that convincingly in round one, but came through in straight games. Last outing he got to the semi-final of the Indonesian Open, but he was saying he's got a strategy that he feels that maybe can upset the odds here against Lee Chong Wei. It's hard to believe he would see it, but Lee Chong Wei certainly says he's taking nothing for granted. It's been a terrific 2013. Six events, six finals, four wins for Lee Chong Wei. And they have met. And last time round, I'd be surprised to know Lee Chong Wei took it. In fact, they've won. They played each other five times previously. All five times have gone Lee Chong Wei, Lee Chong Wei's way. And apart from their first meeting in 2010, Rumbaka hasn't taken a set. What do you reckon then, Steve?
Yeah, it's good that Rumbaka has a strategy. I don't know what the goal of the strategy is, but if it is to win the match, I think Rumbaka and Tommy Subiato, two young Indonesian males and players, they're progressing, and I think you can see them increase their game even more in the future, but I don't think Rumbaka is ready to beat Lee Chong Wei yet. I was a bit surprised to see the scores from Rumbaka's first match against Misha Silberman. Silberman is a very fine player, but he's not that dangerous. He should be that dangerous to the normal Super Series crew, so to speak.
21-15, 23-21 the score, yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, none others, I don't know Rumbaka, Indonesia.
To the stadium.
And on my left, Lee Chong Wei. Malaysia.
Sure.
He's on way to serve. Double. Play.
Andy Schroeder, the umpire here, and Lee Chong Wei with a very comfortable opening point.
One more.
Well, no Taufik Hidayat, of course, anymore for the first World Championships for Indonesia. Well, maybe the tactic is hit it at Lee Chong Wei. seven world championships for Lee Chong Wei. Won a bronze in his first appearance in 2005. Quarterfinals 2006. Third round in 2007, 2009. And up to Sony Kwee Dempura 2010. Lost to the Indonesian Taufik in the quarterfinals before that match against Lin Dan, where he had three match points in London a couple of years ago. So silver and a bronze from six championships so far. Malaysia, of course, waiting for the elusive gold.
You have the multiple match points, there's such a big difference of winning or losing. Prestige wise. In any way, the only way that you should be some kind of satisfied is really evaluating. When it's a 2-point game, it could go either way. It's also a bad one. Especially if you're just 1 point away from winning it all. To do that a number of times, you're eventually going to win it. Just lost some life here.
Yeah, we have. Good start from Rimbaka here, though. Feel with the circumstances as they are, this year is his best year, his best hope. I do anyway. What do you think?
Yeah.
Him today as well.
There's a lot of pressure. If Chenok is to meet Lee Chong Wei in the final, let's just say that this is going to happen. Then Chenok would beat Lee Chong Wei. He would have beaten the king in his own backyard. So don't do that unless you win as a world championship. So there would be this pressure on Chenok in the final.
See. In terms of the fitness, of course. Really settled very well in the opening exchanges here. There's been one or two times where there's been nothing he can do about the supremacy of Lee Chong Wei, but on the whole, he has more than held his own. Isn't it? For Rimbaka. So an inspiration, yeah.
Yeah, we've seen a couple of players really when they come to realise that winning badminton matches isn't, after all, the most important thing in the world.
Barker, and well played.
11-7.
He takes the interval lead here against Lee Chongwei. The Indonesian leading 11 points to 7. Sensed anything in particular in the way that Mbaku has played this match so far?
Hot one, 20 seconds. Hot one, 20 seconds.
It's interesting how he's, Mbaka, I mean, I suppose it's because Taufik's been around, but he's regarded as kind of a rising star. But he's 24, which, it, you know, is not young, is it, really?
No, it's not young. I'm pretty sure that there's coaching changes that's been going on in Indonesia. I think the singles players have benefited from them and will benefit.
And it's kind of strange for them that he's not there. I know I've heard it that the Danes talking about, you know, it was strange at first, Peter Gaeder not there.
Yeah.
But then eventually, okay, now it's my turn.
Yeah. chooses a little bit unwisely, but then chooses to push. Increase the pace. To go.
Lee Chong Wei is going to have a really tough workout here. 3 points in a row for the world number one. Returned to world number one again in October of last year. You know, he's not saying, oh, nothing to lose, you know, I'm not expected to win. It was none of that. It was, no, I've got a strategy, and I can maybe, you know, he's obviously realistic who he's up against, but maybe I can cause a bit of a surprise. We lost to Taufik and to Sony Gunguru, yeah. So three times to Indonesians, is twice to Sony. Opening set. Really long. Lee Chong Wei. Drift working against him there. Wide, and it's game points. Six of them. Murmuring of disbelief, isn't there, inside this arena at the moment?
There is. What on earth is happening?
gave him a hero's welcome, and he's just lost the opening game. Look at that. What a performance from Dionysios Ayavrumbaga. The world number one has dropped a set, and not just dropped it, pretty convincingly, 21 points to 14. Okay, this is Li Chongwei, and he obviously will try and regroup after that. 21-14 to the Indonesian. It's funny, isn't it? Many sporting things, especially when it's knockout, and people were talking in the press conference, Lin Dan, Li Chongwei, all about what a great to find. He's got to answer the questions about, you know, whether in the final against Lin Dan again. There's a few other sports where this, you know, you'd say, listen, that's a long way off.
Yeah, we had an example, I guess it was where Roger Federer said, why are you just talking about a final between me and...
It was a quarterfinal, him and Rafa, yeah.
Yeah. And none of them reached the quarterfinal.
No. Now, of course, I'm not saying Li Chongwei won't overturn this, and I'd still make him favourite here. But it kind of is difficult, isn't it, when everyone's asking you about the final.
Hold one, 20 seconds. Hold one, 20 seconds.
I agree with you that I still think that the bigger chance is that Li Chongwei wins this match. But the task is much, much harder now because he's a game down. And there's only one game. He can only afford to lose one more game. Then he's out of the tournament.
And the confidence now for Rumbaka, who, as we said, felt he had this strategy, and that strategy's worked, the confidence must be high.
I think it depends whether Rumbaka will be able to find the baseline here playing with the wind.
Because Li Chongwei wasn't.
He wasn't, and Li Chongwei needs to move forward because he needs to take control of the net. He needs to push Rumbaka to the rear court to create openings for himself. He also needs to know that Rumbaka isn't going to live until he's absolutely forced to do it. So just the possibility of lifting is not going to be enough. He's still going to play closer than play the front court.
Set's over. 2-1.
It's not a big hole yet for Li Chongwei, but it's certainly a hole.
Controlling themselves because you don't want to get too excited, you don't want to show your player that you absolutely believe this can be done.
Keep your feet on the ground, play every point.
because he doesn't want to get Li Chongwei started. He doesn't want to get him into his rhythm.
Yeah, I agree. You just saw, you know, it's kind of like Li Chongwei's eyes widen, yes. Don't they, when it's being played at that pace.
Finally, I can use my speed. So actually, you'd rather make a fortunate shot than get Li Chongwei going. You could say it's a bit like the Danish-Mexican combination with Chen Shu, where they sort of prone Chen Shu in the first 1.5 game. Lee Chong Wei.
Seven, five.
You just got out the wrong side of bed this morning.
This could be the match that Lee Chong Wei needs to survive.
What we were talking about earlier with Chen Long, yeah? But I know what we were talking about, you know, sometimes a match like this can give you the kick up the proverbial backside.
The difference here was that there was a little bit of deception on the return here, so he wasn't able to move as early as he wanted to, Rumbaka.
Here. He's competed in tournaments, been coming to Guangzhou for 13 years, but yet to win here. Came here first of all for the World Junior Championships 13 years ago, lost in the semis. Lost to Bao Chunlei in the final of the China Open in 2007 here. So although he loves coming here, it's not exactly been arena lucky for him. Foot, isn't he? Time.
Great shot there.
there in the end, just spoiled it, didn't he? Status quo being restored here. 11-7, Lee Chong Wei leads going into the interval. Also to maintain the kind of consistency he was showing, that because he's then going to go around the other side of the net again.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Going to be down to the third game, isn't it? Obviously.
Yeah, I don't think Baka will get back into this game. I don't think he will try too hard either. Perhaps trying one or two rallies to figure out how to play this board in the third game.
Thank you. medicine there. Good response, that's what you have to say it's been from Lee Chong Wei. I don't think we expected anything different, really.
No, he looked a little bit troubled in the beginning of the second game where it was behind 4-1.
And also 7-5, yeah.
4-1 was the more worrying part where it looked like it could be a total breakdown.
Third, isn't it? them a little bit tighter. But just wonder whether maybe Parker should have saved up these points for game three. Left here for Lee Chong Wei, of course. Rebecca's 21-14 in the first game, but I wonder what sort of third game we are set to watch here. It's been fascinating so far. Say that, you mean if Lee Chong Wei goes ahead by 4 or 5 points, or you talking about that?
Final game!
Ibaka goes away. 11-7. I don't think Chong Wei's going to be able to
I'm not,
so to speak, good side.
Yeah, I'm not sure. I having watched what I've watched of Lee Chong-wei, even if he was 18-8 down, I still fancy his chances of coming back. But we shall see how it pans out. Again, he's misjudged it in the opening point. Third set. Given out. It's a questioning look from Rebecca. Not sure if we're going to see the replay. I don't think we are. It was a close one.
Big difference between 4-5 and 3-6.
Maintaining the level.
Six.
There's no doubt about it. Lee Chong-wei is going to have to up things here. they're nervous on the sidelines now. It's like the carrot's been dangled in front of them.
See the coaches when Baga has turned his back to them again. So they're very calm and collected when you can see them a bit more animated when his back is turned.
One game all, 6 points all. To fight for place in the third round of the 2013 World Championships. To be fair to Lee Chongwei, he was saying, you know, everyone's saying what a great draw I've got. You know, I've got some young bucks in this side of things.
Yeah, he's got a reasonably hard draw. I think people have spotted Baka as trouble makers for the watching him. This kind of later today, it's a good chance of progressing to the winner of this match.
After this, should Lee Chongwei make it? At last. Maybe a few Malaysians, Kuala Lumpur, they'll be breathing a little easier at the moment.
Not a lot of Malaysians on the street right now.
Hasn't he, Rebecca? I mean, he showed at the end of the last game, even though Lee Chongwei looked as if he was losing. It was 21-18 in the end. Just give himself a fighting chance.
Big problem scoring.
minutes. So Li Chongwei ahead at the interval. Afternoon so far for him.
This happens sometimes in the early rounds of a tournament. When you press to the semifinal on the final stage, you're so used to playing in the world, so you don't miss time as much as you tend to do in the early rounds.
Thank you. doubt there's been a storm in this match for Lee Chong Wei, but it looks as like he may have ridden it. Danger. Maybe we'll look back on Sunday evening at this match and say it was just what he needed. All credit to Rebecca, who's put in a very good performance.
Like you say, if it doesn't kill you, it makes you stronger. And if this match doesn't kill Chong Wei, good strategy against him. You had to adjust. He hasn't just cruised to the final. He hasn't even cruised to the next round yet. But,
thank you.
We'll be ready. One thing you could say suffers is perhaps his confidence. But, it's not like he's been playing badly. It's been Rumbaka who has been playing really, really well.
Points have arrived.
Match point 11.
And the drama, the theatre, if you like, has been sucked out of this match. And all credit to Lee Chong Wei for that. Because he impressed it in just over. He was given a fright thanks to this super play from the assistant. He was given a massive cheer when he walked onto court here, Lee Chong Wei. And after surviving, the world number one receives a lovely reception as well from those inside the Tianhe Gymnasium. 3 games, and he came through in the end, 21-11 in the final one, and he made that final set look pretty comfortable, didn't he, Steve?
Yeah, I wouldn't say so. It was actually first after the missed time smash from Rumbaka that Chong Wei managed to cruise to victory in the third game. Until then, I thought the match still was open, but it's a match where you're actually a little bit sorry that one has to win and one has to go home. But for the tournament's sake, I feel it was nice that Lee Chong Wei got through.
Yep, the
all
world
to Rumbaka.
Indeed, indeed. The world number one survives and is through to round three. So next up, it's women's singles time. And well, after Chen Long was given a bit of a fright, after Lee Chong Wei was given a bit of a scare, what now for the women's number three seed, Sinet Nawal, up against Olga Golovanova, with the winner to meet Pontip of Thailand in the round of 16. Well, there is the Russian. Vladovanova.